r/AskReddit. What evil prank have you pulled off? Over a decade ago, I worked in the warehouse of a guitar center. We dealt with inventory, shipping and receiving. We had a dumpster behind the store in a shared parking lot that people would leave random things in, even though it was not a public dumpster. One day we found a broken beach chair in an open cardboard box. The box had a shipping label on it. It was left in such a way that it was easy to assume that the chair/box combo was left by the same person. We packed the beach chair in another box and shipped it back to the customer. I wish I was there to see the person's face when they received their trash back via UPS. I lived in Korea for a bit. When my mom came to visit, I told my Korean girlfriend it was an American custom to greet older women by touching elbows. I told my mom the same story about Korean customs. It was a thing of beauty. They were not pleased. Simple, elegant, thoughtfully harmless. The perfect prank. One night I replaced every framed object in my boss's office with a picture of me making a stern face. Posters, certificates, photos, etc. Took like 3 hours because he had like 30 framed things in his office. The next day I made sure I was out doing field work to make him sit with it most of the day. He had a lot of foot traffic to look at his office that day. People in school used to always take my Gatorade. So I took an empty bottle, filled it with diet salt water, and let them take my drink. Not gonna lie, it was hilarious watching one person to spit salt water in the middle of class only for their unbelieving friend to do the same. Early days of networked PCs. DOS and NetWare. I worked in a computer lab on campus. There weren't a lot of management utilities available at the time, so I, and a few other student employees, wrote batch scripts and small programs to automate a few things when a student or professor would log onto the network. Having that sort of access led to numerous pranks being pulled, but most of us were savvy enough to figure it out and undo the prank. However, we had two co-workers who liked to loaf a bit too much for our liking. They were not at all technical and had taken the lab assistant job because they thought it was easy money. They had conspired to be assigned to a remote classroom lab that rarely had any students in it who would need assistance for most of their working hours. They would just sit around and play games on the PCs while the rest of us were, you know, working. Clearly this could not stand. I rewrote a piece of code that was executed when every single user signed on. If the username was either one of these two and they were signing in on a PC in that remote classroom and it was during their working hours, it would look at an innocuous file on the network. The file merely had a few bytes in it which noted how long it had been since this prank had last been triggered, ensuring that it would run once or twice a week maximum. If it did activate, it would launch a terminate and stay resident program which would wait a random time, between 5-15 minutes, and then drop an image of two dudes 69ing on the monitor for a few seconds and reboot the PC. Tested it, put the compiled program in place and deleted the source. Much hilarity ensued for the next two semesters. Edit. Well, this seems to have struck a chord with more than a few. Here's an interesting bit that I did not share initially. This was the late 80s, early 90s, and decent online porn, much less gay porn, didn't really exist. Think ASCII art. So where did I find this image to use? One day I, and a few of the other student workers, were playing around with a new disk utility that helped visualize where space was being used. An important thing in the days of 20 megabytes hard drives. We had meant to use it to see where some of our network storage had gone, but the utility scanned all the drives on a PC, including the networked ones. At the time, as fate would have it, sitting in the CD-ROM drive was a Bull and Turbo C installation disk. It popped up in the final report as having a single hidden directory, labeled XXX of all things, that contained more data than the entirety of the Turbo C installation combined. It was all porn and in high resolution 640x480 VGA glory to boot. A hidden folder containing nothing but pornography had somehow managed to be included on Borland's CD-ROM that had been purchased by thousands of businesses and educational institutions. My mum's laptop wallpaper was a picture of her granddaughter. I copied the picture 100 times and made her wallpaper a slideshow of the same picture over and over again. So the file would change, but nothing would change visibly on the monitor. The pictures would change every 10 seconds. On one of the images I painted a tiny little curly mustache on her. So randomly for 10 seconds my niece would have a mustache. My mum thought she was either losing her mind or had a computer virus, and every time the mustache popped up, it was gone by the time she tried to show anyone. One that was played on me. I took my SATs, college entrance exams. For those outside the US on the 1st of April. Should have known, right? But apparently, I'm not that smart. That night I went out with a group of friends. And when I got home, my mom met me with a serious look on her face. She told me that the testing committee had called, that there had been an error and all the test papers from that day were lost. Everyone was being contacted to schedule a date to retake the exam. She totally sold it. Face, reactions, everything. I bought it hook, line, and sinker. And she let me believe it until lunchtime the next day. My mom is a diabolical person. Not a prank I pulled off, but one I was victim to. My manager had left me in charge of the store when I was 16. Not legal, but that's a whole other mess. For a whole weekend. Saturday went well and I was happy with how I went. Although my paranoid brain is always concerned about whether or not doors are actually locked. I'm the same with my house. But the store was worse. So I make my dad drive down to the store to double check that everything is okay. 15 minutes later I get a phone call from him saying, "Manager and the police are here because the door was unlocked and people were inside." Cue to me on the floor in tears hyperventilating, while my dad is telling my mum, who had since picked up the phone, that he was only kidding and that everything was fine. Working in a hot factory, supervisor and job planner in this enclosed cubicle with a window AC unit in the middle of the shop, aka nice 68, and there while we sweat our ass off in 95-110 F heat, kinda hot and pissy and always flies around, I kept grabbing the flies alive. Walking into the cubicle to ask a usually legit question or say I am just cooling off and opening my hand behind my back, I put 14 of those duckers in there in one shift. He never did catch on I was doing it and the planner was pissed swatting around, there were so many flies in there. Supervisor was cleaning out every crevice thinking some food is supporting life now somewhere. I used to work at a science tutoring center when I was in college and my gap year before professional school. One of the things we taught very often was anatomy. So naturally we acquired a few skeletons and various skulls with some variation in how they looked or were marked, etc. Well, I was closing one night. And I knew my co-worker was opening the next morning early. So before I locked up I assorted all of the skeletons and skulls in a welcome party near the front door. I had one immediately at the opening of the only door into the room with several backup skeletons and skulls just behind at a table together watching on. The best part was that you have to turn on the lights manually and that switches immediately to the side of the door opening. So when she reached down to turn on the lights she had to come face to face with some lifeless skeleton skull in the middle of the shady opening. Needless to say she screamed, and it was loud enough to make our boss come to see if she was okay. Woke up to some colorful texts LMAO. Still proud of that one honestly. Dude was harassing my ex because he used to have her cell phone number. Was being a real ducking creep. Anyways, I created an email address, signed up to Kijiji and placed an ad offering an 80-inch 3D TV for free with some excuse about a bad breakup and not wanting her to get it. I asked people to only text or call. I then went to bed and forgot all about it until the next day at work I get a text from my ex asking if I had done something on Kijiji. The dude was begging her to take the ad down and apologizing. I checked the email and there were 5 pages of responses even though I had told them not to email but to call or text. Dude's phone must have been ringing constantly. I took the ad down and she never heard from him again. Welded a co-worker's boot to the floor. He had worn out the toe caps on his steel-toed boots. While he was making a weld kneeling inside a large piece of equipment, on steel, I put a small tack weld on his boot so he had trouble breaking it loose and getting up. I got pranked. Does that count? Was at a house party at my then girlfriend's place. She knew me really well and knew that I've got a fairly competitive spirit. The place is really dark. She turns to me at the dim light and says, "My name. I bet you can't fit an orange in your mouth and eat it all in one bite." Wasn't about to say no to a challenge so I took her up on it. Only it wasn't an orange that she peeled but a lemon. One summer in college, I worked in the registrar's office, registering all the incoming freshmen. A prof who was a mentor to me was teaching freshman seminar and asked me to handpick a class for her. Straight A students, high sats, whatever. So I did. 15 students, all named Sarah. Kept both regular and honey nut Cheerios at the house because my mom and my dad each ate one type and hated the other. Unless you look close, they appear the same, so one day I switched the boxes. The looks were priceless. Flip the lights on and off while my sister and friends played with a quidger board. Hasn't quite been the same since. I farted under the covers, then pointed at the ceiling above my GF and shouted spider, so she'd throw the blankets over her head. Later when she told her parents, that turned out to be the thing that earned her dad's respect for me, made him laugh so hard he needed an inhaler. When my brother and I were in middle school, my brother liked to skateboard with our next door neighbor. One day, my brother and the neighbor took the sheet of plywood from under my brother's upper bunk bed. No one slept in the upper bunk, out of the house, and started making a skateboard ramp out of it in the neighbor's adjacent yard. My parents had explicitly told him that he wasn't allowed to do that. Now, in my defense, my brother teased me unmercifully, to the point of tears, on multiple occasions. So keep in mind that he had had it coming for a long time. Anyway, an evil little plan hatched in my brain. I ran to the upstairs window and yelled down at them, comma brother's name. Guess what? Mom knows everything and she is SOO mad. Then I slammed the window shut and ran to the stairs and waited while watching my mom read the newspaper. A few moments later, my brother walks in the front door looking worried and says, Mom, I'm so sorry. My mom, who had no idea what was going on, said, about what? While slowly putting the newspaper down. For making a skateboard ramp out of the wood from the bunk bed. You did what? At that moment, a wave of shock and realization swept across my brother's face and our eyes met. I let out the biggest evilest little sister cackle and ran into my room. We are adults now and still laugh about it from time to time. I put hot sauce on my little brother's toothpaste one morning when we were kids. He apparently thought he was being poisoned. Gradually over the course of 2 weeks, moved my co-worker's monitors closer to the front edge of the desk. Like one stroke four per move. Until they were so close the keyboard barely fit. Stupid small desk, she grumbled. Near the end, I then moved them back, just as slowly. Over a few weeks, she never caught on. In high school I went into the boys' bathroom and replaced all the soap in the dispensers with pancake syrup. The AM supervisor at my office is a short little man who likes to work from a laptop on a rolling adjustable desk. For over a year I gradually raised the height of this desk and watched as he went from sitting on a stool, to an adjustable tall task chair, to standing. Last week he removed the wheels from the desk to lower the height. He doesn't realize it's adjustable. Not me, but a coworker collected a week's worth of hole punches, the little white circles that get punched out. Then he got our boss car keys and carefully stacked them on the edges of the vents in his car. Set the AC dials to max and left them. Picked out every last marshmallow from my sister's box of Lucky Charms. Then took a photo of me eating a bowl of just charms. Printed it, and put in the bottom of the bag. I then sealed the bag back up, hot glued the box, and back in the pantry it went. Left a message for an investigator that I worked with to call Elephant about a crucial piece of evidence for one of his tough cases. The number I left was for the Toledo Zoo administration offices. The receptionist played along for a few minutes and then let him down easy. The best part is he called on speakerphone from the chief's office. We had recently moved into a new house and had our plates in one cabinet and our cups in the other cabinet. I switched the plates and cups cabinets and they have since never been changed back. But we still get confused about 3 or 4 years later in our own house. I stuck a pocket kitten on a doorknob at my friend's house. Front door. Rang the doorbell and booked it. I was 14. My mom took my computer away once. And I was really mad about it. So I disconnected the power button from the motherboard on her computer so she couldn't turn it on. My sister doesn't keep anything in her kitchen that she doesn't use. Extras go straight in the trash or to charity. I started buying duplicates of things she'd gotten rid of and hiding them in the backs of cabinets. I found another of her favorite mug. It had been cracked and then wasn't. One of the kids dropped it and hid the broken pieces in the bottom of the trash. Another one appeared in the cupboard. The kid freaked out. She did a wonderful spit take when she was drinking from her mug and unloaded an identical one from the dishwasher. She had plates with concentric circles. Blue on white. I found one with a slightly lighter shade of blue and she wondered if the dishwasher had faded it somehow. Then there was one with the same blue but different rings. And then one with the right blue rings but a different background shade. BTW. It's easier to get away with this if you load the dishwasher and wait. I did this weekly for about a year and a half. She was getting very concerned. I finally confessed when she went to switch out her dishes for the seasonal holiday ones and had more cups than she'd packed. Now with sauces she hadn't had the year before. Evil grin. Note, yes, I know it's called gaslighting. Soaked my brother's entire sock collection with water. That sucks. In the break room. Called my co-worker in. I had a chair. Plastic cup with an inch of water in it, and a broom in the corner. I asked him to help me stick the cup on the ceiling, climbed on the chair, and he held the cup up with the broom. Then I said, "Wanna see a cool trick?" Climbed off the chair and walked away with it. You could hear him cussing and yelling out in the parking lot. Whenever I was playing hide and seek, I'd place stuffed animals in certain locations, such as under the covers on a bed. To make it look like a child was hiding there, I made sure to always hide nearby so I could see or hear the other kids' reaction when they pulled up the covers to see a pile of stuffed animals. It was so funny. I can meow just like a cat. In fact, I can do it so well that people will often look around for the cat that is not there. This has resulted in several hilarious instances of strangers running around frantically looking for the cat and me sitting off to the side watching. Stray cats will usually stare at me for a couple seconds before continuing doing whatever. Pet cats will usually hold a conversation with me, particularly if they're chatty. Edit. The confusion of everyone's pets fuels the lady of cats and she is pleased by your offerings of Reddit awards. Growing up, I had a friend that wasn't exactly that bright. One year when we had to be about 12 years old, he decided for April's Fool he was going to play a prank on his family. His prank was going to be something quite simple. It involved the salt and pepper shakers on the family dining table. He decided that he was going to move the salt from the salt shaker and relocate it into the pepper shaker, and the pepper would be moved into the salt shaker. Basically just a simple salt and pepper switcheroo. Yep, so both of those shakers, they were clear see-through glass shakers. My brother lives on the west coast. I live on the east coast. One night we discovered that there was about a 5-minute delay for a live show. I saw it on broadcast TV about 4 minutes before he saw it on Dish Satellite. During the Oscars, I called him and screamed at him to turn the Oscars show on. He asked why and I screamed at him again to just turn the show on. He said he was already watching it and I told him to keep watching it because somebody blew up the Oscars. I then started narrating what was on the screen and pretending like I was talking to a family member who was in the room with me. I've never seen so much blood. Whose arm do you think that Harrison Ford is holding? Oh. That's Brad Pitt. Without his arm, it's gotta be his. So much blood. My brother asked me what happened when it all started and I described the light and sound of a bomb going off. I could hear my brother excitedly telling his wife what they would be seeing. He asked me when it happened and I told him the last thing that was on the screen was a particular part of a song and dance number. On his TV that moment came and went and he sounded surprised and disappointedly said that nothing happened. Yep, I made it all up. Love you, bro. I went to a party at someone's house whom I didn't like. First thing I did was go into the bathroom and turn their toilet paper around so the roll was on backwards. Everyone who went to the bathroom there saw what kind of Neanderthals the homeowners were. Bro, you made it to the end? You're a ducking beast. I'll cut you a deal. Smash like and subscribe for more curated content, mate. It's free and that's a great price.